talk to me about Activision Blizzard. High on your list.
Yes. So obviously timing is everything, and Tencent yesterday just was a bit of an interesting dynamic. But again, long-term vision of this stock. There's a statistic that said 60% of Americans play some form of a game on a daily basis. And more than 39% of them are older than 36. So we can't blame our kids for this anymore, okay? So again, I'm taking a perspective and saying long-term trend, where are we going? The digital platform of gaming is just starting. Esports is just starting. There's a huge championship going on in Columbus, Ohio, where people are paying $50 per ticket to go and watch other people play games.
They put 11,000 people in the Barclays Center in Brooklyn recently.
So Activision Blizzard, we believe in the long-term trend there. We believe that the company can continue with the innovation and the new slate of games that are coming out,
Black Ops. Why this one, though? Pardon me, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Overwatch.
Over some of the other names that are in the space, Take-Two Interactive, Electronic Arts.
It's the game, right?
It's the game, right.
Not everything is an e-sport. Some of, like, League of Legends, Overwatch, like, there are specific games.
That's right.
So they don't all have that. Like, there's not, like, a big e-sport around Grand Theft Auto, for example.
Exactly. And valuations. We just, you know, we feel more comfortable with that story, the three businesses that have their own unique sort of levers that we think can work for Activision going forward.
We talked healthcare, Abbott Labs.
Yes.
Another one high on your list.
Another one of those diversified med device companies that we believe is in a sweet spot because two of its four businesses are sort of in the recovery mode. Again, long-term secular theme. If you think about folks with diabetes, there are over 400 million people that have some form of diabetes, and only 200 million have been diagnosed, and less than 1% of them are on some form of glucose monitoring system. This is a company that has a new product, the Libre product, that is going to be $1 billion plus by the end of the year. So there's a lot of opportunity here in this one, and sort of gets lost in the shuffle when we talk about biotech and pharma, because it's neither.
Autonomous car supplier Aptiv is up 8%. Year to date, and it's one of your top picks.
It is.
Yana Barton.
It's a $24 billion company that's sort of a gem in the sweet spot of autonomous vehicles. We've talked about active safety, infotainment, shared mobility. These guys provide the sort of the guts of the car, provide all the components. It's trading one multiple below the market and has just as good of growth.
Okay.
Who's the biggest customer in the OEMs?
All the OEMs are.
They're all working with them?
Yeah, okay. And they're partnering with Uber and Lyft and others on the shared mobility.